Fruits.
Work. Do you ever open up a pomegranate and get? I open up a pomegranate and I become exhausted. I open up a pomegranate and then I just take a nap. And then I wake up with a pomegranate in my hand and I go, cool, and I don't eat it. Because fuck pomegranates, but they're so good. Delicious. I'll just go to the grocery. You can get them deshelled or whatever the fuck. You can get a bunch of little that you can get the seeds and shit. In a fuck, I got a text, so I couldn't really articulate that, but you can get the seeds de fucking seeded. And that's nice. So good. The juice is good, but it's something magical about eating a pomegranate seed and it just bursting, you know, in your mouth. Anyway, a durian? Yeah, I have. I heard they smell really bad. I know they smell bad, but they taste good. Blueberries are kind of a fucking useless fruit. Unless you're like a model and you just eat blueberries because like I don't know. They're good for you. They're like they have antioxidants and shit like that. You know? They got fucking free radicals and all those fucking weird shit that you need for your body with weird names. But fuck, man, fuck blueberries. I eat a blueberry and I'm disappointed. And about 9 times out of 10, I'm disappointed in each blueberry that I eat. You ever had a good blueberry though? So good. I love a good fucking blueberry, but it's not worth it. I'm not going and buying blueberries for any reason ever. To have one blueberry. You're paying how much ever a blueberry, a little case of blueberries is for one blueberry. That's kind of good. And that's the best blueberry is the blueberry that's like, that was all right. You know what I mean? No one eats a blueberry and goes, holy shit. I eat mangoes and I go, oh my God. Oh my God, that was amazing. And I become emotional over mango. But a fucking blueberry has never gotten me past the feeling of, it's good. It's an eyebrow raise and a, That's the best blueberry. That's the best reaction that you can get from one of those. Strawberries are a fucking scam. I've never had a good strawberry. I've had strawberries and I've eaten them and kept eating them, and I've been like, this is much too sour for my mouth. But I'm just gonna keep going because I have belief. I believe in strawberries, but I'm not gonna eat them. You know what I mean? Strawberries are a cute fruit. Like they look pretty, they look cute. You know? Candy tastes very good when it's strawberry flavored. We love the scent of strawberry. We like it on our clothing. We like the way they look. We like the way they smell. We like the way the artificial version of them tastes. But real strawberries are a fucking scam. Strawberries are the most full of themselves fruit. I think. Apples are a fucking commitment. And don't get me started about cherries. Don't get me started about cherries, dude. 'Cause everyone always fucking disagrees. And And I don't know if there's anybody out there. Do you guys like maraschino cherries? I like them. I think they're great. I think they're better than regular cherries. Fuck regular cherries. I'm not eating that shit. I'm not eating that with the pit in it. I'm not doing that. And then you leave a bowl of nasty pits. You might as well eat more sunflower seeds, I can do. That's a gross food that leaves a shell that I can eat a lot of. But cherries, I'm not doing. I don't like that. I don't like that at all. I don't like cherries. Fuck cherries. Maraschino cherries are where it's at. Pineapple's good. Pineapples are like the donut of fruit. I'm not eating the whole thing. And it's too sweet. It's too sweet. It's overly sweet. I'm not a huge fan of pineapples, and I'm not a huge fan of pineapple juice. I'll eat some, though. I will eat some pineapple on pizza. Pineapple is made to be placed next to other things. It's made to be grilled, it's made to be heated, it's made to be tossed into other foods, like pizza. Pineapple on pizza is great. Ryan. This is all it takes, dude, to summon you. My friend Ryan always says that pineapple shouldn't be on pizza. But you know what? Fuck you, dude. We could... No. We could go to war. We could. We won't. But if we keep talking about this, I'm going to lose my temper. Or I'm going to lose my cool. I don't know how much of this I can take. You shaming me for my taste buds being correct. Yeah. You have faulty taste buds. Your mouth is broken. I don't know what to say. I'm not gonna say anymore, but we can talk about other fruits, man. Did you know you can eat kiwi skin? You can. Go downstairs, get some kiwi. If you have kiwi in your kitchen, eat the rind. And don't bite into it like an apple. Cut it up. Like a sane human being. And just pop it in your mouth, chew on it. It's like nothing. It's like eating an apple. Now, apples are a commitment, like I was saying earlier. Apples are a commitment. If you're a person that eats apples, you're a wholesome person. You might be crazy. You might be fucking absolutely out of your. You might be at your wit's end, but you've got something going for you. If you eat apples whole, you just eat not whole. I just imagined someone eating an apple whole. Oh my. I'm genuinely laughing right now, just imagining someone putting an entire apple in their mouth and just trying to eat that as is. Like Yoshi. Like a fucking... Who eats apples whole? Anyway, you can't do that. It's completely impossible. But if you eat apples, you might be insane, but... Good for you. It's hard to describe. I don't know exactly how to put it, but you know what I mean. You guys, you know what the fuck I mean. If you don't know what I mean, I don't know what to tell you. But I know a lot of you guys know what I mean. I always look at someone who eats just an apple and be like, damn, I want to be that guy. That's all I want. I just want to be that guy. And I've done it myself. But there's like, their blood is shed when eating apples. Blood is shed. And I say that in the sense that, like, you know. I like this comment. Hold on, let me. I really like this. I like you are piss. But I say that in the sense that, you ever bite into an apple and hurt yourself? Or almost hurt yourself? I can move on, but I feel like when I eat apples, I'm injuring my mouth. But not quite. Like, I'm almost there. It's kind of like torture. I know I'm doing something good for myself. Hi, pretty little things. I'm not getting the dog Malu, no. Apples are definitely like a... Apples are hard. Figuratively and literally. Someone said something about coconuts. You're never gonna see me eating a fucking coconut. Coconut shavings, maybe on a cookie. Not gonna see me eating that often, but will try it, so that I'm not looked at as a cunt. But I've done it before. Don't need to do it again. I don't need to take a spoon and carve with all of my might into a fucking coconut just to get some flavorless, pissy-tasting meat. That's what it is. Coconuts taste like piss. They taste like urine. Grapes. I could do some fucking grapes. I can do some grapes, but you know what grapes I can do? I can do the red ones. That's the only ones I want. I don't want the fucking green sour ones. Apples are ungrateful. Fuck coconut meat, yeah. But... Oh, man. Were we doing grapes? I'm not eating a fucking green grape. That's all for you. I know I used to take grapes and take the skin off of them. Something about that brings me so much joy. Just eating a skinned grape. Like, you take it and you just peel off the skin and then you just look at it like this. And then you maybe bite half of it off. And then you look at it again, and then you just eat the whole thing. And that's how you eat a skinned grape. What about a pear? I don't know, pears are great. Pears are actually on my good side. Pears are definitely in the upper echelon. Pears can be so good. Not quite a mango, but, you know, but pears, not quite. What about meatloaf? I like lychees. They remind me of a massive clit. This was my world. I'd just call it clit fruit. We wouldn't be calling it lychee, lychee, nothing. We'd just be calling it tit fruit. Clit fruit. Hey, y'all eat clit fruit? Hey, you like clit fruit? I like clit fruit. I like clit fruit flavored things, like lychee martinis, lychee puff bar, lychee candy, anything really. Now listen. The fucking god of all. And I say this because when you get a good one of these, oh boy. Oh boy. I could fucking inhale a basket of raspberries. Don't ask me why I called it a basket. It's just the first word that came to my mind. But a good raspberry is a good day. Am I right or am I wrong? A good raspberry is a good day. If a good week, fuck it. If the whole thing is good, sometimes that happens. If the whole thing of raspberries is good, you're gonna have a good week. Fucking love raspberries. If you say I'm wrong, you've never had a good raspberry, and I understand your pain. I do. Yeah, raspberries are, you know, I've had a couple bad ones. You know, they can be mushy and nasty, but believe me, you, they got that, I don't know what the word is, that consistency to them, you know? And that sweetness and that fucking flavor, and they're not sour, when they're not sour, Somebody said blackberries. It's in between raspberries and blueberries, right? You get fuck blueberries. Blackberries. Fuck blueberries. Raspberries, amazing when it's good. Blackberries, when it's bad, good luck. Rest in peace. Because Sometimes blackberries are very good, though. When they have a mild thing about them. When they're not so sour. And I feel like a lot of them can be very fucking sour. Watermelon's so good. I eat watermelon every single day. Every single day. For a long time. You ever had a raisin with a... No. A cranberry? You ever had a dried... Not dried. Yeah, dried. You ever had a dried cranberry with an almond? Have you ever lived? I'm still talking about fruit. You ever had a fucking cranberry with an almond? It'll change your life. Forever. Sheesh. Ooh, a little bit of cheese. You ever put fucking honey on cheese with a cracker? You ever put fucking... Dude, go to your kitchen... Get the fanciest cheese you have. Or really any cheese. Any cheese. It doesn't matter. It doesn't fucking matter. But the fancier, the better. I'm gonna be honest. You ever had brie with honey on a cracker? You don't understand. If you haven't, you don't understand. If you have, you know what I mean? If you have... So good. Velveeta and honey? Yeah, no. Brett, get out. Get out of here. Get out. Velveeta and honey is not even remotely what I am trying to convey right now. peanut butter on an apple is really just a life-changing experience as well. If you put fucking peanut butter on apples, you're smart. Congratulations. You're a genius. You've got it all. You've got it all. You've got it going on if you eat peanut butter and apples. You know what the fuck's going on. You know what's good. Delicious. What the fuck did you just say? Ketchup and cheese Doritos are good. Oh yeah, probably. Yeah. Peanut butter and green apples. Peanut butter and any apple. Any apple. Peanut butter and banana. Delicious. Can we stop talking about fruit? I think we're just talking about food at this point, though, so it's not that bad. But I do feel like we've been kind of... It's been like an overkill with the, you know. Hey, Hollywood Unlocked, can I ask you something? Are you one of those, like, Mojo Watch Mojo people who do the... You do, like, the YouTube videos about celebrities and, like... Shit like that. I don't know what the hype is around Nutella. I think I've seen one of your guys' videos. I'm literally juggling topics right now. I don't want to be inaccurate, so let me just do something real fast. I'm on 5%. Let me see. Yeah, you guys do videos about stuff. Okay, good. I was about to curse you out. I thought you were the one guy who's really, really toxic and awful from one of those other... There's this one guy who speaks on one of those celebrity... What is it? What's the thing... I don't know. He'll do topics like the most expensive things that celebrities have bought. But the guy is so annoying. So fucking annoying. I don't like any of those kinds of things, really. But do what you gotta do, sis. No, there's one person who just is so fucking... you want to punch him. He's like the guy in every movie that plays the douche, and you hate him in real life too because he plays him so well, and you commend him because it's like, you know, wow, great actor, except this guy's not acting. He's really that bad. So... It's some fucking guy who nobody knows his name, but he says his name and before in the beginning of every bit. Hi, guys, and then it's just white noise. His name is probably just... That's his name. He goes, hey, what's up, guys? It's... And we're here today with a video about... The nicest cars that all celebrities have ever bought. And that's it for today, guys. Signing out. And his full name is... ...24. That's his whole name. First, middle, and last. Just, oh my God, that would be a great name. What is this? Well, let's watch the video. Let's stir some shit. Where is he? Oh, hey, can't find him. You can't even find it, because nobody cares. Oh, I found it. I think that it's the guy from...
Cheese bag pizza.
It's the guy... Hold on, where is he? Yeah, there he is. Ugh. I shouldn't show you guys who it is because I don't want everybody to go attacking him, but God, this guy is awful. And then I'll play his voice. Maybe you'll know if I play his voice, but he won't say his name. You won't know. This is so fucking cringe. But God bless him, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do, but oh God, his face, oh.
Your own, and now let's jump into this video. Pizza for $5. The school, all the stager is what came to define her music career, and it's a trait that she carries over into her fashion choices as well. Now, Doja, she often works with the renowned stylist Brett Allen Nelson.
Woo, Brett!
To define the looks of Lizzo, Nicki Minaj, Kylie Jenner, and Charlie XCX. Now, these two, they first teamed up when Doja was looking for an outfit for her appearance at the 2019 BET Awards.
Take a look. This is a moment when you're at the BET Awards. It's
looking to like pink and cat. Well, Brett, he had this to say about the now infamous look. She told me she really liked pink and cats, so the-
Oh my God. Anyway, next subject. I just don't like that guy very much. But it, yeah. Oh boy. Shut the fuck up. Aurora just came out with a song 3 days ago and a video along with it. And we're going to watch that. And I'm going to get my charger because I'm laying on laundry. Oh my God. Oh, she's doing the thing I wanted to do, but oh, I'm too late to do it. I'm still going to do it, but she... One more time. Fucking love Aurora. Jesus Christ. Everyone shut the fuck up. Shut up.
They say there is a war between the man and the woman.
I don't know what else to do with my life other than just watch this.
I've never
forever
felt like this before. My heart knew that I could've. And then you take me in, and everything in me begins to feel like I belong. Like everybody needs a home. And when I take
I exist for love.
be forbidden from loving. Cause when you walked into my life, I could feel my blood begin, like I was torn.
New Jay-Z, you never heard it? For love forever. This new Jay-Z track, boomer as fuck.
I know, I love you so. And then I learned the truth, how everything good in life seems to lead back to you. And every single time I run into
God, this is so fucking good. I want to cry. I'm not gonna cry, not on live at least. This is so good.
Emotion in my veins, and you'll be done.
Oh my God. What the fuck? I'm sorry. One more time. Fuck you. I don't give a shit. I don't give a fuck. You can leave. I don't give a fuck. It literally, I went down like 10,000 viewers in like 5 minutes, and I don't care. That's not what I'm here for. I'm here to listen to this one more time. Fuck you.
Say there is a war between the man and the woman. I've never felt like this before. My heart knew that I could've. And then you take me in, and everything in me begins to feel like I belong, like everybody needs a home. And when I take your hand, like the world has never held a man, I know I cannot heal the hurt, but I will hold you here. I feel like I exist for love. Like I exist for love. Only for love. I can't imagine how it is to be forbidden from loving. Cause when you walked into my life, I could feel my life begin. Like I was torn apart.
This fucking melody is so good right here. That starts right here.
The minute I was only born and you're the other heart. The only thing that makes me whole.
Everything that you heard, bitch, this is the best song in the on the whole planet. Okay, maybe not on the whole planet, but bitch, this is the same feeling I got when I listened to that one bitch that got the name that goes, it goes. I think her name's just O, but her name, it looks like it's parentheses, 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 O. Parentheses, 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 parentheses. This is what this bitch's name is. One of the best songs, in my opinion. You don't have to fucking agree. Her name looks like a vagina, but when I heard this song, I fucking cried. This song, that song, Aurora's song, made me feel the same way that this did. This song is fucking crazy. Listen to this shit.